Hello! In today's video, I will show you how to make a smart air quality sensor that works with Home Assistant. I will use this cheap and dumb sensor from IKEA called Vindriktning, as well as the one mini and Tasmota firmware. The whole procedure is very easy and it will take you only a few minutes to assemble everything. On top, I will show you all of the needed steps in details. So do not worry and let's dive into it. The Vindriktning, that was the dumb and cheap air quality sensor from IKEA that I told you about, is actually not bad at all. It can detect PM2.5 fine inhalable particles. You cannot see these particles with naked eye, but you can inhale them and they can cause serious health problems. The particles, which are less than 2.5 micrometers in diameter, are also known as fine particles or PM2.5, where PM stands for particulate matter. The 2.5 microns or micrometers is actually quite small. It is around 30 times smaller than the human hair. These PM2.5 particles are kind of mixture of solid particles and liquid droplets found in the air, and they pose the greatest risk to your health as they can get deep into your lungs and some may even get into your bloodstream. So, this little cheap sensor that you can get from any IKEA store or you can find it in Amazon can catch these PM2.5 particles and warn you about their increased concentration, which is great. However, the Vindriktning air quality sensor has two drawbacks. The first one is lack of USB-C cable in the package, but that can be easily fixed when you buy one. The second drawback is that Vindriktning is not a smart device. You have to take a look at the LED colors in front of the device. If you see green, then everything is fine with the PM2.5 particles. Yellow is a warning, and with red, the things are bad. Nevertheless, the second drawback can be easily fixed as well, because the Vindriktning air quality sensor from IKEA is kind of smart home ready. All you have to do is to attach a D1 mini that is flushed with Tasmota or ESP Home, and you have a smart air quality sensor that works with Home Assistant for dirty cheap price. And because D1 mini is mini in size, it can fit inside the case of the IKEA air quality sensor, so at the end, nobody can tell that you have modified your sensor unless it opens it up. But enough sweet talks, I'll first install Tasmota on the D1 mini and then I'll attach it to the IKEA air quality sensor. Let's get to action! I'll connect the D1 mini to my computer. And I'll open the Tasmota web page and I'll click on this install Tasmota using a Chrome-based browser web address. Make sure that you're indeed opening this web address with Chrome or Microsoft Edge browsers. I'll click on this drop-down menu and I'll search for Tasmota All Sensors, this one. I'll click connect. I'll select my D1 mini device and I'll click connect. Install Tasmota All Sensors. I'll tick this erase device and I'll click next. Install again. My D1 mini started to flash. Do not close this window during the flashing process and I recommend to don't even minimize it. Installation is complete. I'll click next. I'll choose my Wi-Fi. This one is okay. I'll type my password. Connect. And my device is connected to the network. I can click on visit device. And this is the Tasmota custom firmware. It says son of basic. We have to change this. I'll go to configuration, configure module. And I'll click on this drop down menu. Unfortunately, there is no D1 mini here. So I'll choose generic, which is perfectly fine for our task. And I'll click save. The device will restart. Okay, the Tasmota has been restarted and as you can see here, it says generic. This is my module. I'll go to configuration again and I'll choose configure module again, but this time I'll select this D1 GPIO5 and I'll search for my Vindriktning and I'll click save. That's it, I'm ready with flashing Tasmota firmware on my D1 mini device. The D1 mini is now Tasmotized. And it is time to connect it to the IKEA air quality sensor board. I'll unscrew the screws of the IKEA sensor so I can access the board inside. And I have to solder 3 thin wires on the Vindriktning board. I will use this blue wire and I'll solder it to the ground pin of the IKEA air quality board. Then I'll solder this red wire to the plus 5 volt pin. And finally, I'll solder this green wire to the rest pin of the Vindriktning air quality sensor. After that, I will solder the other end of the wires to the D1 mini. The 5 volt wire will go to the 5 volt pin of the D1 mini. The ground wire will go to the ground pin of the D1 mini, which was labeled with G. And finally, the rest wire, in my case the green wire, will go to the D1 pin of the D1 mini. After I'm ready, I'll cut the mustaches and this will be the final result. The next step is to carefully insert the D1 mini into the case of the IKEA sensor and to screw the screws. I successfully soldered the D1 mini to the IKEA dump air quality sensor. Let's see, will it get a bit smarter? Now, if I connect the IKEA air quality sensor, it is starting to work. This is some internal checks. And if I refresh my Tasmota webpage, I'll see the 2.5 micrometers readings. Great, it is working. Perfect. Before we continue to the Home Assistant integration, I want to personally invite you to join my Home Assistant webinar. If you are still confused about the different installation types of Home Assistant, this 45 minutes webinar of mine will clear the fog around that topic. I will show you all of the official ways to get Home Assistant, plus one secret and stupid easy way to get it. The webinar is completely free and you can register on my website, automatelike.pro/webinar. Now, let's go back to the Tasmota web interface of the D1 Mini to enable Home Assistant auto-discovery option, as well as to configure the MQTT broker. Before I go to my Home Assistant, I have to do few more changes in my IKEA air quality sensor. This is the Tasmota web interface. The first thing is to go to configuration, configure MQTT. And I'll enter my MQTT broker credentials here. If you still don't have MQTT server, you can install one by go to your Home Assistant add-on store, and this one is perfect, MQTT Mosquito Broker. You can install it as Home Assistant add-on and you can then type your host IP where Home Assistant is installed as MQTT host. So I'm going to do exactly that. This is my Home Assistant IP. The username is my Home Assistant username and the password is my Home Assistant password. Simple as that. If you have difficulties with the MQTT broker installation, I have a video for you where I'm explaining everything. I'll click save. The device will restart. Next, I'll go to configuration again, but this time configure other, and I'll change the device name to something more meaningful for me. For example, IKEA Air Sensor. And I'll type this as well for this friendly name. And I'll click save. The device will restart again. From what you can see here, the device is not Tasmota anymore. It is IKEA Air Sensor. The final thing that I want to do is to enable the auto discovery of this Tasmota device. For that, I'll go to console and I'll execute the following command. Set option 19. Space 0 and I'll hit enter. This will enable the Home Assistant Tasmota auto discovery. And I think I'm entirely ready with the Tasmota configuration. Now I'll go to my home assistant. And because I'm using a lot of smart home abbreviations and acronyms in this video, and not only here, I prepared a smart home glossary for you that can help you further. Inside this glossary, you find simple but quite useful explanations of the most used words and acronyms in the smart home world. You can download that glossary free of charge on my website, automatelike.pro/glossary. Now let's continue to the home assistant and Vindriktning IKEA air quality sensor integration. So finally, this sensor to become a smart one. This is my test installation. I will press the C button on my keyboard and I'll type integrations. And I'll click on this navigate integrations button. It is quite possible your Tasmota device to be auto-discovered right here, but because I did some tests, it is not. And in my case, I have to add the Tasmota integration manually, which is very easy. I'll search for Tasmota, I'll click on this button, and I'll click submit. And as you can see, I have IKEA air sensor detected. I can click finish. And if I click on this one device, I'll see the Vindriktning 13 micrometers of PM2.5. Great! Now I can add an automation very easily. Just for the demo, do something when IKEA air sensor concentration changes. Exactly what I wanted. I'll click on this. When air goes bad, this is the name of my automation, the name doesn't matter. And when the concentration goes above 35, this should be equivalent to the yellow light of this sensor. So if the concentration of PM2.5 goes above 35, this sensor is showing yellow light. Okay. And the action can be anything, actually. That's the beauty of Home Assistant. It can call you, it can send you notifications. But just for the demo, I'll create the very simple notification code persistent notifications. So choose call service here as service. I'll select persistent notification create. And as text, I'll type PM2.5 goes above 35. Okay, of course you can add more actions, for example, to start a fan, to start the air purifier, to open a door or anything. I'll click save and my automation is ready. To test this, I'll go to developer tools and for entity, I'll search for IKEA air sensor, this one. The current state is 14 and I'll change it to 40. Set state. And my notifications are immediately increased and I can see my text PM2.5 goes above 35, which means everything is working as expected. Great! As usual, next week I will release a new smart home related video for you. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!